Welcome to Occupy, a reader's theater of perspectives, written by poet laureate of Alameda, Mary Rudge. The Occupy movement, with its bold call for justice, born on September 17, 2011, captured the hearts of poets everywhere. They produced and continue to produce Occupy-themed poetry with readings at protests, cultural centers, bookstores, in online journals, at general assemblies, and on these airwaves.
I dedicate this work to Raymond Zach. Raymond Zach was depressed because the government cut his employment funds. He walked out into the bay off the Alameda shore, and even holding up his hands in the universal sign of I surrender and help, and with a rosary in one hand, stood there until he died of hypothermia as the police, the firemen, the Coast Guard, families picnicking on the beach, windsurfers, all went by. Or just went on doing their thing. Or, in the case of the firemen and police, watched him. And when he was dead and floated in the water, an unidentified woman went out and pulled him to shore. And no one was responsible. Because Raymond Zach's employment was caring for other people who couldn't care for themselves, he was depressed because he wouldn't be able to care for those that he was caring for, as well as for himself. Nobody called out and said, come back, we want to help you. Nobody called out at all. He was just one of the occupants. But because it was very close to home, I live in Alameda. My children grew up running and playing on the shore there, and that was part of our happy life. I just can't get that out of my mind. I dedicate this work to Raymond Zach.
And now, curtain going up on Occupy Readers Theater by Mary Rudge, Alameda Poet Laureate.
Pepper spray.
I was 19 when the pepper spray filled my throat, when the police turned the can to my face and aimed at my eyes. In the hospital, they said, sometimes the retina damage is permanent. They said damage to lungs and sinuses, to throat membranes and other organs may return to show again far in the future.
The bus rider.
The occupation disrupts the buses that the poor ride to the food banks and clinics, yet they must get there. The working poor with low-paying jobs, the workers, others, unable to drive, they will be rerouted. They will be late for their jobs. They will be let out to walk far to the next bus that they must transfer to. The bus won't be able to get through the crowds. I will not be there at the time I must pick up my child from daycare. The buses have been rerouted. The people with walkers and wheelchairs must find the bus they must transfer to. The transfer now is long away. They have no cars. There are things they must carry. Some cannot walk so far in the rain, in the cold. They are too ill or too old.
Second policeman, the rookie.
I don't want to see no more dead kids. I want to clear out the dealers, drive-by shooters, the crime. I got a son myself, and I'm barely 30. Who knows what cause will come in his day? I know how my dad in Vietnam, I didn't join no army to beat and kill. Now the Occupy is taking up our time. These people are not invaders. They're friends and neighbors.
On the news tonight, now to a close-up zoom of the newscaster as she says,
what is their plan? They occupy. Then what? No one knows.
So the woman who knows the news said, and so signed off.
You think this is the end? Watch us begin.
Be a butterfly, can move her wings in Cuba, and cause a tornado in Tennessee. One person can change everything. Here we go now.
You just heard part one of Occupy, a reader's theater of perspectives, written by poet laureate of Alameda, Mary Rudge. Part two will be broadcast next week at this time. The poems in part one were read in order of appearance by...